I need to start eating better. My body is not going, it's not happy. And I just, all this travel and the drinking, and then, I'm shoving two freaking crustables in my mouth. Like, as Jillian said today, all I need to eat is air and lettuce. I just really need to, like, dial it back on things. And so I was like, fine. This morning, as I was at DFW, this is my last bad meal. Hi, I'd like a toasted plain bagel, please, with a lot of strawberry cream cheese.
You're a strawberry cream cheese
gal? So good.
What? Yum. Are you kidding me? That's like the 12-year-old EA. I don't know anyone that's into a strawberry
it's
cream cheese.
So you're delicious. Adorable. And then I have to sit there in my seat as everybody's walking by and I've got my mask on and I'm just like, spreading it on my bagel and then taking my mask off and eating it. I'm like, I'm so gross, but it's so delicious. But yeah, I really like tonight's the night. I'm gonna watch the Bucks and the Giants and eat well.
I had this morning, this is what I do. I'm not a bad eater, but I'm a very,
you don't eat a lot.
No, but that's not good. Like I have like struggled my whole life because I have a very bad metabolism. This is just a thing. It's genetic. Fine. That I have to really pick my calories. Like, where am I going to spend these calories? And if it has to be for wine, then we've got to like make concessions somewhere else. So do you know those perfect bars? The ones that I eat like all the time. I think Jackie and I have talked about this. Like I've been eating one every day for like the last four
this
years.
This reminds
so
me
annoying.
Of Mean Girls. It's like, but yes.
I want to kick the...
Well, why? Those bars which that bar? She thinks will make you lose weight. Well, it gives you a lot of calories right away and then you'll lose weight after. What?
Yes. And so that's the perfect bar in the morning. Well, I'm all out of perfect bars at the house. So do you know what I did? I ate chocolate chip cookie dough for breakfast. Because to me, it was like basically the same thing. Yeah. I have it, the Toll House one in the refrigerator. And I was like, well, it's kind of the same as the chocolate chip like bar in the morning. So again, does it matter where the calories are spent? No. Like I took three scoops of it and that was equivalent to the bar. And I was
you're
like,
making fun of me for having strawberry cream cheese, but you're eating raw cookie dough for breakfast?
It's all that was there. In my fridge, I will not let Kyle go grocery shopping because I don't want food in the house that I know I'll eat. It's a real problem. Like, I make him just get food outside the house at all times. If you open up my fridge, there's like, I'm not kidding. There's water, there's Diet Coke, and there's cookie dough in there.
God.
It's fine. But earlier this week, so midweek catch-up with you consists of a lot of different things, but more times than not, when I call you while you're at home midweek, is you're walking how now. And you were walking him this week, and there was a moment where there was a poop bag incident where he had already went to the bathroom and you used the poop bag and then he went again and you didn't have another one and you were negotiating, like talking all about how you had to come back to get another bag and if anyone saw you leave
it's
the
so
poop
embarrassing,
and there was a whole thing.
Right? You feel like you're doing the so walker run of shame when your dog goes to the bathroom and you don't have a bag because our neighborhood's really small and people obviously know who we are. And so he took a huge dump and I was like, oh my God. And I actually, what happened was I didn't bring one because this was not a time he usually does them. He does a morning or night, but this was an afternoon poo. And I was like, wait, where is this coming from? Yeah. So I was on the phone with you and I had to like truck it to, we have a nearby church, which they're nice enough to put poop bags out. I just always feel like people are watching and then they're like, there she is, that shitty neighbor running away, leaving her dog shit. But I like ran back as fast as I could to scoop it up. I also feel like I have to say something out loud to Howie in case the people are looking at me through their window. I'm like, we're going to go get a poop bag, honey, and we're going to come right back.
I'll take it one step further. These rings will get you.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? Because I do not want to be in this neighborhood and all of a sudden that ring zooms in and I'm the asshole with two of these dogs just losing their mind in the front yard because if someone did that to me and I caught them on a ring, I would expose them. So I'll say this, like, I'll say out loud, same thing. I'll say like, I can't believe you guys are going poop again. We already used up one of your poop bags. And like, I'll make sure that I like come back with like grocery bags so that they see today Kyle went and took him down this like side street or whatever. And he walked out without a poop bag. I knew it. I watched him on the camera and I was like, son of a bitch. I was like, we cannot be caught on camera without cleaning up the poop. I raced down the alleyway with a grocery bag because we're out of the poop bags. And I was like, you better clean this thing up. He's like, what is going on? I was like, we cannot be those people. No. I cannot be caught on camera not cleaning the poop up. I've had it so bad where I've had to take leaves leaves and like debris that's around and then try to pick it up. Now it's on the hand. Now we're walking. The dog's pulling you. It's a whole thing. But I'd rather have that than be accused of being a poop leaver.
Yeah.
You know,
I've had it so bad where my dog has had the runs and he has just like painted somebody's like really nice marble like front of their house. And I'm like, oh my God. And one bag is like, I'm just like finger painting, smearing it everywhere. And I'm like, oh my God. So I run home. Of course, I say something out loud in the air. I'm like, wow, this is messy. I'll be right back. But I come back with like a water bottle to like clean it off. Like it just feels terrible. And actually a lady was watching me from another house and she's like, thank you so much. That would have been awful to leave it. And I was like, I know, I'm mortified. Yeah. My dog just...
How about at the dog park to take this one step further? You take the dogs to the dog park. They're running around. I'm not monitoring their every move, okay? It's a time for me to catch up on email. I'm looking down. I'm looking at the phone, and I get this. Excuse me, ma'am, is that your German Shepherd? And I'm like this, like, oh, God, she's mauling someone. What's going on here? That's a very large poop that she just did over there. Are you going to clean it up? And I'm like, well, yeah, I was getting to that. The poop that I didn't see, but yes, sir, I'm getting to it. Like, I would never point that out to someone in the dog park.
I know.
Calm down. Dog parks
give me so much anxiety. Anyway,
I know they do. Wait, which brings me to another story. So when you're on the road with a girlfriend, or let's just say like you're, you know, whatever, like you and I are going out for the night or something like that, and I have makeup in my purse. Or a makeup bag, more than makeup bag, but just in general, do you ever get embarrassed or feel like you have to explain when someone asks to borrow something like makeup wise, like a lip gloss or like use the brush and the bronzer? Because there's this whole thing, like if Jillian's like, hey, can I borrow something out of that like bag of yours? And I'm like, I feel so embarrassed because she's a makeup artist that I have to explain that my makeup bag isn't as nice as hers. And I'm like, oh, sorry, that's like dirty or that's like not nice. Like it's like a cheaper brand or something like that. Do you ever have that? Like,
no, because I think she knows already that I'm a hot mess and it's fine. So, I mean, I will say this loud and proud, and then you wonder why I complain about getting zits. I don't know the last time I cleaned my makeup brushes. That's fucking disgusting. I don't have time. I'm, you know, like, I don't know. And I don't feel like I wear makeup enough. But again, why am I doing videos and complaining about the cystic acne? Well, probably because I haven't washed a makeup brush.
Also, did you just get so fucking dark in here?
I don't know. It's kind of dark in here too.
I mean, what time does it go dark at? I feel like I'm like sitting in the dark. No, the reason I'm saying that is because I'm always so embarrassed because like when I go out, like I'll take a blush brush and just throw it in the bottom of my purse. Well, like a quick touch up, and then someone like sees me pulling that out of my purse. They're like, ew, that's where you carry your brushes? And I'm like,